What is up, YouTube? Welcome to my channel. I'm Mr. Make Life Happen. Hope you guys are having a super blessed day because life is so good. Today, I want to talk about the secret of causation. The secret of causation. Our divine imagination contains all that we desire. It reproduces itself through our human imagination. So this tells us that our human imagination contains everything that we desire in our life. The entire world is our human imagination externalized. Until you realize this, you will continue to rob yourself from your unfulfilled desires, from your unfulfilled dreams. The world plays its part based on what you imagine every single moment in time. When you rise or lift to the point of vivid imagination, you will resurrect your desire and it appears in the world of man. Everything in this world is first created in the human imagination. There is no other God. You can use your imagination to create heaven on earth, but you can also use it to create unwanted things in your life. If you look at scripture in the book of Isaiah, it tells us, I create good, I create evil. I, the Lord, create all things. So this tells us that the power within you, you can use it to create heaven on earth, or you can use it to create unwanted things. But you can use this knowingly. There's only one power in this universe, and this power is called Lord God Jehovah in the Old Testament, and it is called Jesus Christ in the New Testament. Your imagination will create any reality that you desire. Your assumption of yourself, that is the key to creating your desire. When you assume yourself to be something specific, when you assume yourself to have your wish fulfilled, that is having faith. If you don't have faith that your assumption will be fulfilled and will come into reality, you will continue to imagine all the things that you imagined before, and you will continue to create those things from the past. Whatever your desire is, whatever you want in life for yourself, continue to see yourself as the person you want to be. What would it really feel like if you were the person you want to be? Continue to use your imagination and your mind's eye and see yourself as the person you want to be. If you want to steer the course towards a specific goal or a specific desire, you must become aware of the end that you are molding with your imaginal scenes. If all evidence shows otherwise and you begin to feel doubtful, continue to persist in your assumption. This is the secret of causation. You must feel the end in its reality. Feel the possession of your desire all day long. Feel it in the morning time, at noon, and at night time. As you continue to do this, it becomes a habit, and with habit, it becomes practice. After you begin to practice this art of imagination, you begin to flow with it a lot easier, and you begin to manifest much faster. And remember, feeling is the secret. Feeling is the secret, so you must feel yourself having it already there in your reality. So you are the dreamer pushed out and then shaped with your imaginal activities. So our bodies are like virtual reality suits. So for example, if a doctor gives a patient a sugar pill for some type of ailment, this patient then goes home, takes the medicine, a few days later they feel better. So the patient got better, not because of the sugar pill, but it was because of the thought and the image of themselves feeling better. They believed that the medicine was going to make them feel better, so they began to feel and see themselves getting better, and all of a sudden their pain or their ailment was gone. So this tells us that the mind is very powerful, and it proves to us that we can create good things, and that we can also create bad things. Your human imagination creates belief, and your belief is what creates your reality. This is how you carry yourself. So let's take another example. If you imagine a baby, an infant, a really small baby smiling. So close your eyes now and imagine a really small baby. Or if you have kids, imagine when your kids were a small baby, you were holding them in your arms. Imagine a really small baby smiling. Hold this picture in your mind's eye and see the baby smiling. What happens? You begin to smile too because it feels real. When you see the baby's face, it feels real, and this naturally creates a belief. What you believe, this is how you carry yourself. So let's take, for example, another one. a rose. You can close your eyes and vividly imagine a rose, and what happens? You begin to smell it. The world is our imagination pushed out. Any conflict within the world is actually conflict within ourselves. It is not on the outside, as most would like to think. Change your intentions and watch them animate within you. Control your imaginal thoughts, or others will control them for you. When you imagine for others, imagine with love. For God is infinite love, infinite power, and infinite wisdom. You are the author in writing your very own play. Imagination creates all reality, and you can prove this to yourself. This is the secret of causation. Either these teachings are true or they are not. There is no in between. If you say you believe in God, then believe in your own human imagination. Our imagination is the power and the wisdom of God. There's only one power in this universe, and we call it Jesus or God. But if you believe Jesus Christ to be on the outside, then you will never know him, and you will never know God. God is not an outside source, because he is a person, and you are a person. He became us so that we may become him. Begin to apply this from now on, and you can become the person that you've always wanted to be. Don't dream about your desires from the outside. Dream from your desires. Think from your desires and awaken those dreams that you thought were never possible. The right people will gravitate towards you. They will reflect on how you've been carrying yourself and what you assume yourself to be. When you begin to change, they change. Remember, where the mind goes, the feet soon will follow. Where the mind goes, the feet soon will follow. You are the dreamer. You awaken your dreams with vivid imagination. When you begin to live your dreams awake, you return to the true being that you really are, the Lord God himself, the Creator. Live your dreams awake and imagine the best, because you absolutely deserve it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Stay tuned for my next video. Stop reacting to what is. Stop reacting to what is. Don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe, hit the bell icon. Go out there and use your gifts and make life happen. Peace.